Golden Globe. Now she's Tony nominated for a performance on Broadway, the place where it all began. She's talking with our Tracy Smith.
What in God's name is happening down there?
Who the hell are you?
Tony.
If you happen into New York's Belasco Theater in the next few weeks.
What in the actual is going on? What are you doing here?
You might be on familiar ground. A family reunion.
Rachel.
At full volume.
Rachel, Tony, what the hell was that?
How long was I supposed to sit here and let her insult me and my daddy? Our daddy, you piece of...
What?
The play is Brandon Jacobs Jenkins, Tony nominated, appropriate. And the human volcano on stage is Sarah Paulson.
Guess what? If there is a sick person in this family, it's you.
Can you sum up what appropriate is?
I thought you were about to ask me if I could sing.
And I was
I know you
can't.
No, I cannot sing.
Yes, you can.
A little bit? Just kidding. appropriate is essentially a family drama-con.
My father is dead! Our father is dead! The only man we all share is dead! And we
and
are
it's pretty heavy on the drama. The play's about siblings coming together after their father dies. Secrets get revealed, feelings get hurt, and very little is left unsaid. As the older sister, Tony, Paulson is in her element.
You know our father wasn't guilty of one thing that witch just accused him of.
Creating a character who's both powerful and vulnerable. It's a bit unlikable.
So do you not have that need to be liked? As a person, I'm like, please like me. Please. I'm begging you. I'm like a puppy dog that way. I mean, of course I want to be liked.
But as an actor.
But as an actor, I feel like I don't think about it at all.
And she still can't believe it's her name above it all on the marquee. She says seeing it for the first time was a shock.
Then I did cry because I thought, this is something I never could have imagined. I mean, my mother spent a lot of time taking me to the theater when I was younger because she was a good mom who knew that it was really a passion of mine.
Her mom, Catherine Gordon, understood it all. She wanted to write. And when she and Sarah's dad divorced, she moved her two daughters from Florida to New York City in search of a dream. And in what turned out to be the omen of a lifetime, she found work as a waitress at the legendary Sardi's restaurant on 44th Street, the very epicenter of Broadway. Sarah wound up at LaGuardia High School for the Performing Arts.
What memories are coming back?
Do you hear that?
Where she did her best to stand out.
We had kids whose names were like Lene and Romy and Suna and Soren, and I was like, my name is Sarah, and so I'm going to change it. And I had everyone call me Sarah.
Are you serious?
I'm deadly serious.
And after graduating in 93, she was really serious about finding work. She skipped college and went to Broadway. And before long, she went from on stage to on screen. Playing everything from a sketch comic opposite the late Matthew Perry.
Or we could just end it now. The fight.
That'd be fine too.
First of all, could you stop telling people we broke up because of the national anthem? It makes me sound like an idiot.
To an especially cruel slave owner.
Same as the rest, and that's the bunch of you work, that's all.
And then she really got busy. In the series American Crime Story, she was unforgettable as prosecutor Marcia Clark in The People vs. O.J. Simpson.
I'm not a public personality. This isn't what I do. I don't know how to do this.
That role launched her to the next level, but she still has yet to watch it or anything she's done since.
So you didn't watch it? I've never watched The People vs. O.J. No. Sterling K. Brown is always like, Mama, you might want to check it out. I'm like, maybe I do, but he's like, it's pretty good.
But you think he'll pick it apart?
I know I will pick it apart.
Paulson's just as clear-eyed about her personal life. She and actor Holland Taylor, who's 3 decades her senior, have been together since 2015, though at the moment they're working on opposite sides of the country.
When do you get to see Holland? Well, Holland and I live separately.
Why?
I think, you know, I don't know if you know this, but Helen is a good bit older than I am. And she lived a lot of life on her own. And I lived a lot of my life on my own. And I think we both sort of arrived at this relationship sort of recognizing that we both wanted to maintain some of that. And we were both sort of adult enough, I think, to say, I don't want to give this up and I don't want to give this up, so let's be together, but let's also be separate, which is lovely.
I have to say.
At the same time, do you miss it?
Oh, God, yes.
Oh, God, yes. We get along great on the FaceTime.
Oh, my God.
And some things happen only in New York, like this. Last week, Sarah Paulson had her portrait added to the caricatures of immortals that have adorned the walls of Sardi's for generations.
I love it. It's going to be my new headshot, if that's okay.
The very place where her mom once worked. The man with the picture is Sardi's owner, Max Clinovicius, who hired Sarah's mom back in the day.
You're also honoring my mother for being brave enough to move to Manhattan at 27 years old to follow her personal dream and to thereby give me a giant springboard towards my own.
It's hard to describe the feeling in the room, but you can see it all in the face of a former Sardi's employee.
How proud are you, Mama?
Oh, I've been proud of Sarah since the day she was born.
She was happy.
And it's going to make me cry.
Not only is Sarah Paulson now a Sardi's laureate, she's been nominated for a Tony for her role in Appropriate.
All this life you live, what's it for if no one's there to tell you about it?
Sarah's a fabulous actress, and I know that. And I think she's going to win.
Mom!
I do! I do!
All right.
All those seeds that were planted in her early days in New York, now in full bloom.
Pinch me, is what I feel. Pinch me, and just if this is a dream, I don't want to wake up. I mean, we all have dreams as children, right? And some of us get to experience them. And I feel like I'm getting to experience it, and it's really special.
Mom jeans. She passed them down to you, but who passed them to her? Those mom jeans helped make her who she is. Show her with Ancestry DNA. This Mother's Day, she can see the tricks she inherited, the places where they started, and the people she shares them with. Best of all, it's on sale for Mother's Day. Get it now, before she has to remind you.
Thank you.